So here we go. Let us have two points A, and this over here is point B, tangent at A, and this is tangent at B, and then the angle over here is nothing. Hi everyone, this is Manas, your friend and tutor, and guys, in today's session we are going to take a look at the moment area method for calculating the slope and deflection at any given point on a beam. Beam kaisa bhi ho sakta hai, it might be a simply supported beam, a cantilever beam, or an overhanging beam, whatever it may be. After watching this entire video, let me make a claim, let me promise to all of you that after watching this video, you will be able to work out the slope at any point in a beam. Because in today's session, we are going to be looking at only theorem number one from the moment area method. So let's jump right into it. But before that, there are some points which you need to remember, guys. Watch them one by one. Point number one. What's point number one? Okay, so you've got to be skillful at making the bending moment diagrams. भाई अगर आपने शेयर फोर्स और बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम्स नहीं बनाए हैं देन देर इज अ बिग प्रॉब्लम. द नंबर वन रिक्वायरमेंट इज यू नीड टू नो हाउ द एस एफ एंड बी एम डायग्राम्स कैन बी बेंड, एंड टू बी वेरी स्पेसिफिक हाउ द बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम्स कैन बी बेंड फॉर एनी बीम. इट कुड बी अ सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम और अ कैंटिलीवर बीम और एन ओवरहैंगिंग बीम और अ फिक्स्ड बीम. इट कुड बी वॉट एवर, यू शुड बी एबल टू ड्रॉ इट्स बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम, एंड ओनली देन विल यू बी एबल टू अप्लाई the theorem 1 and theorem 2 of the moment area method. Okay, so that is the first requirement. And if you don't know how to make the bending moment diagrams, then you better watch my videos on shear forces and bending moments, right? The links to those videos can be found in the description down below. Go ahead, check them out, at least 3 to 4 videos. Just try to see how bending moments can be made, what is the sign convention, and once you have seen that, well, you can switch over to this video and you can explore the entire moment area method, right? Point number two. Okay, ma'am. By ma'am, I mean to say, not a madam, it's ma'am, moment area method. It's a semi-graphical technique. Why are we calling this a semi-graphical technique? The reason being very simple. A bit of graph, a bit of diagram making, that is the moment diagram making, a bit of results from those diagrams, and a bit of equation solving. That is why we are calling this technique as the semi-graphical technique. Right? And number three. Well, guys, when we started this video, this is started making videos on deflection of beams. This is, I guess, the 11th video in this series. So we have already taken up methods in the form of double integration. We've also seen a lot of problems on Macaulay's method. And this is the third method which we are discussing. Right? When we derived the first formula, you must remember this, the first formula, the slope deflection formula which we derived was this. Isn't it? EI y double dash by y double dash is the d2y by dx square is equal to mx. Now, while deriving this formula, we had assumed a few points, and those assumptions are going to be same in this case also, in the case of moment area method also, not to worry. Okay, we are going to be dealing with them one by one. Anyway, and finally, there are going to be two theorems. Theorem number one is going to be all about slope. And theorem number two is going to be all about deflection or the vertical displacement of tangents. Bataenge aapko acche se, theek hai? I'll be explaining you each and everything in detail. Pura dhaga khol ke rakh denge. Right? Each and everything, each and every detailed will be conveyed to you. Not to worry. So let's jump right into it. And let's see theorem number one. And guys, here we go. What you need to do is you need to consider the beam. Okay. So there is a support over here, roller support, hinge support. Let's have a beam. Here we go. Let me just show that to you. Right? Theorem number one. First of all, let us see what theorem number one says. And there is obviously some kind of loading over here. Right? Some kind of loading. What sort of a loading is this? Can you identify? So it's a uniformly varying load. Right? There is no order in it. And this is just a hypothetical case. The loading could be concentrated, the loading could be uniformly distributed, the loading could be uniformly varying. It could be whatever it wants to be, but you should be able to find the slope and deflection at any given point on a beam. Sikhate hain kaise karna hai, theek hai? What we need to do now, or what the theorem states, theorem 1 states, let me just read out the statement for you all. Here it is, just go through this. Kuch to keh raha hai wo. What is it trying to convey? So it is trying to convey something between the angles, or rather it is trying to convey something between the tangent and angles subtended in between those two tangents. Just take a look at this. the angle measured in radians between the tangents at any two points on the elastic curve. So let's make the elastic curve, guys. Let's try to understand this. Let us make the elastic curve. Here we go. That is the elastic curve, isn't it? And let us make two points, A, and over here let's make B. Let us make tangents at these two points, at A, that's the tangent at A, and that is your tangent at B. If you watch carefully, what is this theorem trying to say, right? The angle between the tangents, tangent at A and tangent at B, equals the area under the M over EI diagram. I, as well as all of you, have never heard about M over EI diagrams. What we've heard is M diagrams or the bending moment diagrams, but until now we have never heard about anything about M over EI diagrams. This is a bit confusing. Not to worry. Let us take a look at the theorem first, and then we'll get into more detail as to how this theorem got evolved. Let's see this. So this angle over here is equal to the area under the M over EI diagram between these two points. Don't worry, everything will be explained, right? This is just the start. You might be confused. Not to worry, as the session progresses, ultimately all your confusions will ebb away. Sab hawa ho jayega, bilkul tension mat lijiye. Okay, here we go. So this angle is nothing but the area of bending moment diagram between A and B. Let me just try to explain the in a nutshell. This is a beam, isn't it? That's a beam. Some kind of loading is there, whatever it may be. So it obviously deflects, something like this. If you try to make the bending moment diagram, let's say this is your point A, that's your point B. So that's the tangent at A, that's the tangent at B, and this is the angle, right? So this angle over here, if you try to make the bending moment diagram, it might be like this. This angle is equal to the area under the M over EI diagram. This is the area, okay? This angle, this theta is actually equal to this area of which diagram? M over EI diagram. Sab samajh mein aayega, abhi acche se proper diagram sab aapko dikhai de rahenge. Theek hai? Not to worry. So let us get into the details of theorem number one, and here we go. Let's say we've got a beam over here, right? So there are two supports, roller, hinge, okay, uniformly varying load, whatever it could be. And let me just rub this off. Let's get into the details. And once you understand this technique, things are going to get very easy for you as far as slope calculation at any point on a beam is concerned. Okay, here we go. Point A, and let's say over here we have point B, right? Let's make another figure. Okay, this is a small element, a very small element. The length of the beam, let's say, is L, and somewhere along that length, somewhere in between A and B, we have considered a very small element in the form of dx, right? Fair enough. Okay, let's proceed. Obviously, because of loading, initially the beam was absolutely flat, absolutely horizontal, but once you put in some loads, it is going to deflect from its original position. The original position was horizontal, and it is going to deflect like this. Okay, so I'll be making an exaggerated figure. Theek hai, ye dekhiye, elastic curve kuch aisa banega, something like this. The elastic curve would be looking something like this, don't you think? Right, this is an exaggerated figure. Thoda bada chada ke curve ko jyada banaya gaya hai. Understanding my point? Why? Because we want to learn the concepts, that's why. Okay, originally the beams do not deflect like this, and if they start deflecting like this, then the job of the civil or mechanical engineer who was in charge of this structure making will be in danger. Naukri khatre mein aa jayegi agar beam is prakar se deflect karega to. Sahi bata rahe hain aapko. Theek hai? So make sure the beam, the deflection in the beam should be minimum to such an extent that it should not be visible to the naked eye. Okay, although there is some deflection in the beam, right? You cannot avoid it completely. So here we go. Let us have two points A, and this over here is point B, tangent at A, and this is tangent at B, and then the angle over here is nothing but what? The difference of angle between the two tangents. Let me just write this properly. There is a proper way to read this angle, okay? And that way is theta B2A. How do you read this? This is nothing but the angle that the tangent at B right? So this is one way of reading it. Okay, so let me show that animation once again. So we've got two points A and point B. So you make a tangent from A, you make a tangent from B, right? So this is this angle over here. What we call this is theta B to A, angle that the tangent at B makes with the tangent at A. That's it. Or makes with respect to the tangent at A, whatever you may call it. Now what to do? Just take a look. Okay, just take a look at this element. Confused? Don't worry. It's something like this. It has got to do something like this. So you have initially a beam like this. Okay, you have a beam and then you have a very small element, don't you? And this is having a length of dx, right? So the beam is going to bend in this fashion, isn't it? So one thing is for sure that the element is also going to bend like this. So when you zoom into this element, this is what I have made, and here it is. Watch it over there. When you zoom into this element, this is what you shall see. That's it, right? Understood the point? Let's proceed now. Okay, what else? So we want a proof, a mathematical proof from the theorem, right? So there is going to be a lot of mathematics involved, a lot of calculus. Okay, here we go. So this dx over here looks like this distorted one. Okay, somewhere in between A and B, we have this small element dx. It has been zoomed and it has been made over here. And some portion of elastic curve will appear here also. Let me show that to you. Okay, it's a sagging bending moment. The beam is bending in this fashion. So it's a sagging case. And that's why you have this positive bending moment, sagging bending moment, trying to bend the beam in this direction, right? Anyway, so this element is right in between A and B over there, right? So we will consider two ends of the elements. This is the leftmost end of the element. Let us make a point over here. Where are we going? Let me make it a point. And this is the rightmost part of the element, this part of the element, which is close to B, you can say. Let us again make a point over here. Now guys, if you watch carefully, points A and points B, point A and B, both of them are far apart. Right, the distance is quite significant, and if you make tangents, then there is obviously, if you make tangent at A and if you make tangent at B, there is clearly an angle between those two tangents. Okay, now these angles are very very small. Let me tell you, very very small. I have made an exaggerated figure. Itna aisa bend hota nahi hai. Bataya na maine. Agar aisa bend hua to naukri khatre mein hai. Theek hai? Koshish karna aisa jeevan mein kabhi na ho. Anyway, so in between these two points, we have selected an element. This element is extremely small, right? An infinitesimally small element, aisa kehte hain calculus mein. What we'll be doing is, we'll make a tangent at this particular point. Here we go, we'll make a tangent over this point, and the angular difference is again going to be very small. For a very small element, the angular change is going to be extremely small. For a dx element, the angular change is going to be d theta, and that's exactly what I'm going to write over here. That's d theta for you. Okay, how can we proceed now? Not to worry. So, tangent, angle between the tangents, d theta. Let me make a normal over here. With respect to this tangent, we can make a normal here. And with respect to this tangent, we can now make a normal right here. Those two normals are going to intersect somewhere right here. And obviously, if the angle between the tangents, look, this is the tangent. If the angle between the tangents is d theta, therefore the angle between the normals, well, it's also going to be equal to, well, this is going to be d theta. Let me just show that to you. Okay. Now we need to apply some common sense, something which we have learned at school level, right? Theta is equal to arc over radius. That is the formula which we are going to apply. Okay. One more thing which I need to tell you. Now guys, the beam was like this initially, right? We considered a very small element somewhere here. And we said that this is what? This is dx. And the beam was loaded. So the beam bent. So the element became something like this. Now this is something again which we'll consider to be dx. The difference is so small, right? The curvature, this is looking a larger curvature, but in reality the curvature is very small. So it makes no difference if it is absolutely straight or curved. So you can say this is equal to this. If this is dx, this can also be assumed as dx. Provided this theta, this angle theta is extremely, extremely small. Okay, that is the entire idea. Again, let me tell you, when the beam bends, this curvature is extremely small. This may look as if this is a larger curvature, but it's not. The curvature is the curvature is such that the angle subtended over here is very small. You can say this. If the angle subtended here is extremely small, then the straight line dx can be assumed to be this arc over here, that is dx. You can make this assumption. Okay, now let us try to apply which we have learned at school. Let me show that to you. Here we go. Just take a look at this figure. Theta is equal to arc. How much is the arc? If that is dx, this also is going to be equal to dx arc upon radius. So this is something which this is radius, right? This is radius of curvature, you can say. So let me just write this. Theta, what theta? D theta. D theta is equal to arc. Arc is nothing but dx over radius. So you can write it like this. Very simple, isn't it? Now what needs to be done is this. Watch. Now this is something which we have already used in the bending equation. Let me tell that. Pure bending or equation of pure bending, people usually call this. Now you should remember this from bending equation. Let me just write this. From bending equation. I think all of you must have gone through this. From bending equation, what you have is M over I is equal to sigma over y is equal to E over R. This is a very popular formula. If you have gone through bending stresses, you must have come across this formula in each and every case, right? So this is the bending formula which we will be using. You can clearly see M over I is equal to E by R. So if you take this E over to this spot, so M over E I will be equal to 1 over R. So what we can do is, I can write d theta is equal to dx times of 1 by R, and in place of 1 by R, I can replace it by M over E I is equal to dx times of, kya likhe isko? Yahan pe alag se likh deta hu main. 1 by R is nothing but M over E I, right? You can understand. Just try to equate these. 1 over r is equal to m over ei. When you plug in this value of 1 by r is equal to m over ei, here you will get d theta as, and this is an extremely important result, d theta is equal to m upon ei into dx simply. But what does this convey? M upon ei into dx. Just a second, let me check if the shoot is still on. Yes. Okay, so what sort of an information is this equation conveying? A very important case. Let me just give this some more respect and enclose this into a box. What information does this convey? You need to think about this. This is very interesting. Okay, let me make some space. Khali slide. Okay, let's make some space for ourselves. All the diagrams are gone. Just think about this. What can we do now? Here we go. Let me show you something. This is very interesting. And just take a look at this. Theorem 1, isn't it? Here we go. This was our beam. Alright, that's the beam. So we took an element over here. The name of the element was dx, or the length of the element was dx, right, which was along the length of the beam, and obviously there were some supports, let's say over here and here, a roller support and a hinge support, whatever. Now this is what we've got. Let's say that the beam is subjected to some kind of loading. The loading could be anything like this, let's say, right? Now if I were to make the bending moment diagram of this, just take a look at this. Very interesting case, and now you will get the essence of theorem number one. What exactly this means, you will get a look. Okay, so if I were to make the bending moment diagram, I would do something like this. I will make this
It's good now. Okay, and that's the x-axis, and this axis is meant for the bending moment. Let's call this as M, simply M.
If you watch, the bending moment would be, well, would be something like this, and it would end somewhere here, isn't it? The bending moment would be something like this, isn't it? Okay, now if you watch carefully, what this dx is, dx is a product of M upon EI times of dx. This small length is dx, okay? So if I can just extend this, beautiful, and extend this, what would you call this? What is this length? This length is nothing but dx. And if you just take a look at this, take a look at this rectangle over here. This entire bending moment diagram can be sliced into small rectangles, and this is an extremely small rectangle, right? The height may be significant, but the width of the rectangle is extremely small. It's dx. So this is the area of that rectangle. And if I were to ask you, what is the area of the rectangle? Area of the rectangle. You would say, sir, the area of rectangle, or let's call this as a rectangular strip, area of the rectangular strip would be a product of bending moment. This height is how much? That is bending moment. Okay, right here, bending moment, whatever it may be, multiplied by what? Dx. So one thing is clear, that this M into dx represents the area. Okay, and when divided by EI will mean that this M over EI, this M over EI, whatever the bending moment you have, you just divide it by EI. EI is nothing but a constant. E is a Young's modulus, and I over here represents what? The moment of inertia. Okay, area moment of inertia. Just a second, let me check. Yeah, everything is clearly visible. Here we go. So this small expression over here is a product of two elements, this M over EI and dx. Let me tell you something else. So in calculus, especially in integral calculus, we've gone through this. Let's say this is the curve y is equal to f of x, and let's say you want to find the area under the curve between x is equal to a and x is equal to b. So area under the curve can be calculated by integrating it from x is equal to a to x is equal to b, and this f of x dx. You can also write this as, instead of writing f of x, you can also write this as y dot dx. So what this is trying to convey is, this is nothing but y, and this as usual is dx. So in place of this y axis, what we have, what we initially used to have was m, but now what we'll have is m over ei. Remember, area of rectangular strip is m over ei times of dx. Okay, and this eventually is nothing but the area. Not the area, but the change in angle, you can say this. So this is how you can actually relate mathematics with a bit of mechanics of materials. Okay, I think you've got the idea. Now let's go ahead. What we want to do is, let me go back to which slide, slide number 3, I guess. Okay, here we are. This small angle over here, d theta, is equal to this much area, only this much area, right? Dx multiplied by this height is nothing but m over ei. Whatever moment, the bending moment diagram you make, you simply divide that by EI. That is going to be our corresponding M over EI diagram. Simple. With the help of some examples also, I'm going to be explaining you. Don't worry, everything will be understood. But that will only happen once you watch the entire video. Okay, so this d theta is area under M over EI diagram between these two points. So what we want is the angle between A and B. Angle between A and B is this theta B to A. Theta B to A, angle that the tangent at B, angle that the tangent at B makes with A, right? Okay, how can you do this? You simply need to integrate. Integrating from A to B. When you do the integration, what you need to do is, you need to write like this, theta A, this is going to be theta B, this is going to be d theta, is equal to m over EI dot dx, and obviously this is an integration right from a to b. And what does this integration represent from a to b? If you ask me, what is this a to b, what does this integration of m over ei dot dx represent? Let me tell you, between a and b, so a point was somewhere here, guys, and point b was somewhere here, isn't it? So if you just mark it up, that's a for you and that's b for you. So the area between, that's a for you and that's b for you. Area between, just take a look at this, right? This is going to be theta b minus theta a. That is quite obvious. Okay, I don't need to tell that. This is the area. Beautiful. Don't go far, don't go beyond this point. Stay inside. Here we go. That's it. अब आपको बताते हैं कौन सा चीज क्या दिखा रहा है. इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी एम बाई ई आई डॉट डी एक्स, एम बाई ई आई डॉट डी एक्स, वाई डॉट डी एक्स. दिस इज नथिंग बट वाई, वाई डॉट डी एक्स. दैट्स द एरिया. ओके, एंड दैट इज द एरिया, एंड दिस इज बिटवीन पॉइंट ए एंड बी, राइट? सो हियर वी गो, लेट्स राइट द फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन. पर कहां लिखें? आई गॉट टू मेक सम स्पेस. लेट मी रब दिस. ओके, किधर लिखें? डी थेटा, राइट? सो व्हेन यू इंटीग्रेट दिस, दिस इज गोइंग टू बिकम डी थेटा बी माइनस थेटा ए, एंड दिस इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू दिस इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम ए टू बी, एम ओवर ई आई डॉट डी एक्स, एम ओवर ई आई एक्स एंड डी एक्स. दिस कंप्लीट इंटीग्रेशन इज द एरिया under m upon ei diagram between points a and b. Let me write this mathematically first. A to b m over ei dot dx. You can also write this as area under m upon ei diagram between points a and b. Theorem 1, in a nutshell, is represented by this equation. That is theorem 1 for you, of the moment area method. Now, how to apply it and how to get the value of slope at distinct points in a beam? Wait for that. Okay? There you go. Right? Difference in angle, that is equal to area under this. Okay, tangent at A, tangent at B. In a nutshell, it's like this. Tangent at A, that's point A, that's point B. Tangent, this is theta B to A. What is theta B to A? It is nothing but tangent at B, tangent at A. What is this equal to? Area. Area under M over EI diagrams between points A and B. That's it, between point A and B. This is M over EI diagram between point A and B. Whatever this area is, that by default is equal to this. Okay, so I'm pretty much sure that you must have got the gist as to how this technique can be applied. Now let's go ahead and solve some examples and let's try whether this is working or not. Okay, and you can also verify your answers with the help of either double integration technique or Macaulay's technique, right? Just to check whether you're getting the correct answer by this method or not. Let's jump right into it. Kaha banaye? Okay, here we go. So guys, let us begin our journey with konsa case lene. Let's take the case of a cantilever beam, okay, with a concentrated or point load at the free end. Let's see how things work out, okay, whether we are able to apply this method or not. Now this is going to be example one. Let's start example one. Here we go. Kya nikalna hai isme? Let's make the beam first.
Okay. अरे यार हाथ मुड़ जाता है थोड़ा सा. आई एम अ परफेक्शनिस्ट, यू नो, परफेक्ट डायग्राम बनना चाहिए. सो वी गॉट अ पॉइंट लोड
पी एट द फ्री एंड. लेंथ ऑफ द बीम इज एल. व्हाट यू नीड टू फाइंड इज, लेट्स से दिस फिक्स्ड एंड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय ए, दिस फ्री एंड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय वी. व्हाट यू नीड टू फाइंड इज, यू नीड टू फाइंड द स्लोप एट पॉइंट पी. दिस इज व्हाट यू आर सपोज टू फाइंड. हाउ कैन यू डू दिस? By applying the moment area method. Batate hai? Okay. Watch out. Okay. The first thing that we'll try to do immediately is make the bending moment diagram. All the calculation will be done over here. Okay. Let's try to make the bending moment diagram.
Oh, let me make a reference line. A reference line. That's nice. Okay. This is x, and this over here, whatever the bending moment diagram is, m over ei diagram is also going to be same, okay, of a slightly lesser magnitude, right? Because this is a constant, it does not change with length. So whatever the bending moment diagram it is, the corresponding m over ei diagram will be proportionally smaller, but not to worry. Anyway, so this over here, if you just try to take a look, the beam would bend. Initially, it's like this, but when you apply the load, the beam would bend like this. And if you see, what kind of a profile is this? This is a hogging case. And whenever it's a hogging case, the bending moment is negative. So all the values of bending moment that you are going to get from A to B, all of them will be negative in nature, except at this point, because this is a zero bending moment case, as it is the free end, right? So how can we find the bending moment? Oh, okay. Just take a look, the maximum bending moment will be right here at the fixed end. How much P multiplied by N? So this point over here will be the maximum bending moment. The value, let me just write this, P L L, that's it, a negative value. You know why it is negative? P multiplied by N, that is the bending moment. But since it is trying to bend the beam into this form, a hogging case, that's why we'll put a negative sign over here, that is minus P L. And if you go ahead, you are going to find the bending moment at all the points also. Let's say you want to find the bending moment over here, right at the center. So this is going to be equal to how much? P multiplied by this L by 2, P L by 2. So if you keep on making them, you'll have different points. You'll have different points. And finally, when you join all those points in proper sequence, let me just draw this. This is what you are going to do. That is the curve. Not curve, but simply the area, right? All the points are negative. Okay. So generally, itna time lagta nahi hai. Pehli bar main aapko samjha raha hun. This is the first time I'm explaining you this concept. That is why I'm spending some time into the explanation. Right. In the upcoming problems, I'll not be spending so much time. Don't worry. And with practice, you can solve the slope and deflection problems in seconds. Let me tell you. Okay. What we need to do now, we want the slope at point B. Okay. Kaise nikale slope at point B? It's very easy. Here we go. Let me show that. It's very easy. Right? Let me extend this further. So if you watch, let's say I want to draw the tangent at A. Right? The tangent at A would be something like this, absolutely straight. Don't you think? This is the tangent at A. Now, the beam would bend somewhat in this fashion. Let me draw this. The beam would bend somewhat in this fashion, isn't it? Isn't it? Oof. So, this right over here is point B. This is point A. And if I were to make a tangent at B, it would be something like this. This will qualify as the tangent at point B. And if I can just retract this, wapas piche leke aao yahan pe. Now, let me just write this. This is the angle that the tangent at B makes with the tangent at A. What makes tangent, angle that the tangent at B makes with the tangent at A, theta B to A. Okay, now your objective is to calculate theta B. Let me just write this over there. You can see that theta B to A is nothing but theta B minus theta A, and it is equal to area under M over EI diagram between points A and B. Between points A and B. So between point A and between point B. How much is the area? This is the area. That's quite obvious. This is the area that you need to work with. Between points A and B, this is the area. एक बार और करते हैं, हमको यहाँ पे निकालना है. देखिए यहाँ पर टेंजेंट खींचा आपने, यहाँ पर टेंजेंट खींचा. So you've made a tangent at A, you've made a tangent at B. The angular difference between those two tangents shall be equal to the area in the M over EI diagram between A and B. So this is the area that you need to work with, and it's a negative area. Why? Because this is negative. Okay, that's quite simple. कुछ लिख दें क्या? Let's say this is A, this is A dash, this is let's say this is B. So area A, A dash and B. You just need to calculate this area and that's done. Obviously, tangent at A is absolutely straight, which clearly indicates that theta at A is going to be equal to zero. Theta at B is equal to B, what? We don't know. That's a question mark, and that is something which we need to work out. It's quite simple now. Theta B minus 0 is equal to how much is this area? You just need to work out half of base. Base is how much? This base of the triangle is L. No worries. Height is negative PL, isn't it? So just plug in the value negative of PL. There you go. That's it. And one second. This is not just PL, since this is PL is the bending moment, but that has to be divided by EI. So this is going to be PL upon EI. This is going to be PL upon EI, and that's it. Minus PL square upon 2EI. Theta B is equal to minus PL square upon 2EI. So this is exactly how you can apply the theorem number 1 to work out the slope at any given point on any given beam. Right? Let me just make a quick check. Dekh lete hain isme. Minus PL square upon 2EI. That's it. This is exactly what the slope at the free end of this cantilever beam is. Okay, ek aur example hai. I've got one more example for you. Right? A simply supported beam case. We'll be finding out, working out the slope at three distinct points. Dono support pe slope nikalenge aur ek aur point pe eccentric rahega wo. Usko bhi dekhe. Now, there is one more thing which you should try. You should try this approach. You should verify your answer from Macaulay's. Karke dekhe kya? You should verify your answers from Macaulay's method. Shall we do it? Aap log karke dekhna. Verify. Aa jayega. Karke dekhna aa jayega. Karke dekhna hai. Chalo, main bataun. Kaise karenge? Let's see. Let's apply the Macaulay's method. So you've got a beam like this. You've got a point load over here. The length is L. And what we need to do is we need to apply the Macaulay's technique. For applying the Macaulay's technique, we need a moment. Now, this is fixed. If I remove this support, then this is the beam. Already there is a load acting. So just for neutrality, there is going to be another load P over here. Okay, summation of F of I is equal to zero. P multiplied by L, this is the bending moment. So this is the counter bending moment. If you remove the support, that support has to be replaced by this bending moment. What is this? This is PL. Now let's say we take a section of the beam. We take a section over here, right? This is the portion of the beam, left of the section. If you take the section from the left, the bending moment at this cross section will be Mx. So this over here is P, and what is this? This is PL, right? So when you do this, when you take the moment is equal to zero, okay? With respect to this particular point, you take the moment is equal to zero. We'll try to frame the moment equation at any cross section or along the length of the beam, and we'll integrate it to get the equation of slope. Let's see if we get the same answer or not. Okay, you can apply the double integration technique also. Okay, there is absolutely no difference, and that too for one point load. You don't have to worry much. Kaise kare isko? So where shall we begin? We are taking moment about this point. Already there is a moment, anti-clockwise, positive. So this is going to be mx. P multiplied by this distance is nothing but x minus px. It's clockwise bending moment. This is anti-clockwise, isn't it? Plus what? P L. Okay. Let's say we are applying the double integration technique. Right? Don't worry. Everything will go fall in place. Not to worry. Let's say we are applying the double integration technique. Just try to follow this. This is very fundamental. So all of this is going to be equal to zero. And if I were to calculate double integration method, DIM, right? MX is going to be equal to P, kya hai? PX minus PL. Fair enough. And you know very well, this MX is nothing but EI D2Y by DX square. I'm writing this as Y double dash. When you integrate this, the stuff that you are going to have is EI Y dash is equal to PX square over 2 minus PL X plus a constant. Now you want to find the value of this constant. For finding the value of this constant, just try to apply this boundary condition. Boundary condition says that at x is equal to 0, at x is equal to 0, that means you are right here. Okay? The slope is also 0. Over here, the beam bends in this fashion. What? Like this. Okay? So the slope over here, at this point, you can see the tangent is absolutely horizontal. That's why at x is equal to 0, as the tangent is horizontal, the slope, that is y dash, will be equal to 0. Y dash is equal to 0. So just plug in the value, you are going to get the value of C1 is equal to something. 0, 0, 0, C1 is equal to 0. So let me just write the final equation. EI, Y dash, instead of Y dash, let me just write this as theta. Simply theta. Okay, theta is equal to P X square by 2 minus P L X. That's it. This is going to be your slope equation. Now you can plug in any value of X and work out the value of theta at that particular point. Now what we'll try to do is, we'll try to put the value of X is equal to L. X is equal to 0, and this is going to be X is equal to L. At X is equal to L, we want to find the slope. Just plug in the value and you shall get the answer. Kidhar kare? Idhar jagah banaye? Okay. Make some space. E I theta. So at x is equal to L, that means somewhere here, that point is point B. So this is going to be E I theta B is equal to P L square by 2, lagate P L square by 2 minus P L into x, x is equal to L. Okay, so minus P L square. Let me again make a check. X is equal to L square by 2. Okay, adha me se ek ghatao, minus adha. So that's it. Is equal to minus P L square by 2, and that's it. Theta B is equal to minus P L square upon 2EI. Now, again, some of you guys might be thinking, what is this minus sign signifying? Ye minus sign kya cheez ko represent kar raha hai? Well, guys, let me tell you. The negative sign shows that the slope is continuously decreasing. Negative sign indicates that the slope is continuously decreasing. Make an arrow over here and write down, negative sign indicates that the slope is decreasing in nature. It's a case of decreasing slope. Okay. So if it was positive, it would have been like this. If it is a decreasing slope, it is like this. Okay. That's it. Want to see one more example? Well, we can. Let's see that. Ek aur example dekhte hain. Let's see this. Here we go. Okay, guys, just take a look at this problem. What we need to find? We need to find the slope at A, slope at B, slope at C. So first of all, we are going to work out the slope, working out the slope at point C. Again, we need to find the bending moments, or you can also say we need to make the bending moment diagram first of all, right? The M over EI diagram, not just the bending moment diagram, but it is the M over EI diagram. How to make it? Let me just show that to you. This is going to be fairly simple. The first thing we need to do is we need to work out the reactions. So obviously, if you remove this support, can I remove it? Yes, I will. On removing the support, you are going to have a reaction here. And this distance, by the way, let me just tell you, this is L by 2. The entire length of the beam is L. So half of it is towards the left and the remaining half is towards the right. This is also L by 2. Let me just remove this also. Here we go. So again, the load is exactly at the center, so it would get equally divided. This is going to be P over 2. This is also going to be P over 2. Not to worry. Okay. And then there is this point, point C. Point C actually lies at a distance. This much is L by 4 from the center. L by 4 from the rightmost end also, you can say.
Okay, you need to find the slope here, here, here. How can we approach this very problem? It's a bit interesting. Again, difference between the angle of the tangents is equal to the area, right? Area under the M upon EI diagram between those two same points. Batate hain aapko kaise hoga. Zara dekhiye. सबसे पहला काम देखिए, बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम बनाना. सो इट विल बेंड इन दिस फैशन. सैगिंग केस, ऑल दी बेंडिंग मोमेंट वैल्यूज आर गोइंग टू बी पॉजिटिव, दैट्स फॉर श्योर. सो ओवर हियर, राइट, दिस इज नथिंग बट
एम ओवर ई आई.
ओके, वॉट एवर बेंडिंग मोमेंट वैल्यू गेट यू गेट, यू जस्ट डिवाइडेड बाई ई आई और राइट इट एज एम ओवर ई आई. डोंट वरी, don't think much about this. Okay, so this is increasing x. Here we go, right? Just think about this. What could be the value of bending moment right here at the center? Bending moment at the center, just think about this. So guys, just take a look at this much portion of the beam. We have a beam over here. Over to the left of this point D, right? This is how much? That's L by 2 and that's P by 2. And we want the bending moment over here. You can also consider the rightmost portion of the beam, right? In that case, we'll have a load over here that is P by 2 and the distance from this section is L by 2. Whichever case you take, it is going to bend the beam. This load is going to bend the beam in this fashion. Sagging case, a positive bending moment. So P by 2 multiplied by L by 2 is going to be P by 2 dot L by 2. In this case also, if you want to take the bending moment about this point, the beam is going to bend in this fashion, isn't it? It's a clear cut case of sagging, positive sign. How much? P by 2 multiplied by L by 2. Okay, so that is the bending moment. That is, this is nothing but M for you. And when you divide that M by EI, you'll have P L upon 4, that is M. When you divide it by EI, you'll have P L upon 4 EI. That's it. That is why I've written P L upon 4 EI at this very point. And all the remaining points, well, they are going to be something like this, sort of a linear nature. Don't worry, much more complex shapes will be dealt in the upcoming lectures. I'll be taking some really uncomfortable and tough problems. Don't worry. Okay, this was just an explanation. So the bending moment diagram is done. So if you've got the bending moment diagram, not the bending moment diagram, बार बार मुझसे गलती हो जा रही है, the M over EI diagram. Okay, once that is done, things are going to get very easy for you. Right, क्या निकालना है पहले बताओ, क्या निकालना है, ये निकाले. Let's calculate theta c. How can theta c be worked out? For that, let me make the elastic curve. Okay, let me just make a straight line first of all. Okay, that's good. The beam would certainly bend in this fashion. This is an exaggerated diagram. Itna bend hota nahi hai. Maine bataya na, itna agar bend hone laga beam, toh naukri khatre mein. The beam generally does not bend this much, right? The bend is very less, not even visible to the naked eye. Anyway, so where are the points? That's point D for you. Let me just mark them. That's point D. Okay, and if I were to make a tangent at point D, well, that would be something like this. Beautiful tangent D. Okay, this is nothing but point A, that's point B, that's point D, and where is point C? Somewhere here. See the niche. Okay, let me just try to do this properly. Okay, that's point C.
right? Drawing. Mark circles.
Okay. Watch. टेंजेंट एट ए, मेरे और कहाँ निकालना है, ए पे निकालना है और डी पे भी निकालना है. डी पे बिल्कुल सीधा है, थीटा डी इज गोइंग टू बी जीरो. ओके,
दिस इज अ नोन फैक्ट, थीटा डी इज जीरो, स्लोप एट डी इज जीरो बिकॉज इट इज राइट एट द सेंटर, राइट, वेर एवर यू हैव द मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन एट दैट वेरी पॉइंट. एंड दिस इज नोन टू अस, दिस इज क्वाइट ऑब्वियस. वेर एवर यू हैव द मैक्सिमम डिफ्लेक्शन ओवर देयर, दैट स्लोप इज गोइंग टू बी जीरो. एंड देन यू गॉट दिस. Let me just write this tan C, and then you've got tan B,
right? सब कैलकुलेट हो जाएगा, टेंशन लेने का नहीं. मैं बता रहा हूं कैसे करना है इसको अप्लाई. वॉच, लगाए थ्योरम, थ्योरम लगाए तो कुछ नामकरण कर देते हैं यार इसको. लेट्स से दिस इज A, let's say this is D, this is D dash, let's say this is C dash, and let's say this is B, right? What we need to work out is, kya nikalna hai, C nikalna hai, C nikalna hai, not to worry, C and D, between C and D, let us apply the M, what theorem number one, between points C and D. So what we'll write is, theta C, angle that the tangent at C makes with the tangent at A, angle that the tangent at C makes with the tangent at A, nahi, let's say this is D, makes with the tangent at D. One angle has to be known to us. Ek angle agar pata nahi hai, to phir dusra kaise nikaloge? Right? Whenever you apply the equation, one of the slopes should be known to us. Then only apply. Otherwise, you will reach nowhere. So between these two points, if you watch, you want the slope at C. We already know the slope at D. How much? That is D. So apply the theorem, theorem 1, between C and D. So angle that the tangent at C makes with the tangent at D. This angle right over here, कहां से बनाए, ऐसा करके बनाते हैं. This angle over here is angle theta C. C to A भी बोल सकते हो, A नहीं, C to D बोलोगे, ये कहलाएगा तो theta C ही. Right? Let's try to do this C D. Here we go. This is going to be equal to theta C minus theta A, just like B and A. Okay, point A was here, point B was here, like this, tangent at A, tangent at B, B minus A, this is going to be C minus D, C minus D, this is going to be area under M over EI diagram. What are the points, what are the areas that we are speaking about? We are actually interested in this area. Okay, area under M over EI diagram, fine, but between what two points? Between C and D. So between C and D, this is what we are interested in. Okay, that is the area which we are interested in, right? So D, C, C dash, D dash, D, C, C dash and D dash, correct? This is fairly simple. You see, what I'll be using is area of trapezium. I think a trapezium looks something like this. Let's say this is S1, this is S2. S1 and S2 are parallel sides, and this over here is the difference or distance between the parallel sides, you can say. So area of trapezium is equal to half of sum of parallel sides S1 plus S2 into the distance between them. Distance between them is nothing but L. Similarly, that same concept can be applied over here also. Or what you can do, you can take this figure and you can split it up in a triangle plus this rectangle. So area of triangle plus area of rectangle, following that logic also you can calculate the area. I'm going to be applying this area of trap. Okay, watch this. Theta C, theta D, area half of sum of parallel sides. These are the two parallel sides. What is the bending moment over here? PL upon 4EI. So let me just write this. PL upon 4EI. Okay. We are yet to calculate the bending moment at this very point. Can be done very easily. Let me tell you how much this would work out. Isko thoda sa yahan pe mita rahe. Isko C ko yahan pe likhte. Ye point C hai. This is point C. Okay.
So you want to find the bending moment right here. You can do, you can consider this much portion of the beam and find the bending moment, or you can consider this much portion of the beam, CB portion of the beam. Let's say if you consider this portion CB of the beam, right? C, you want to find the bending moment about this point, and that's B. And at B, you already have a load. How much? That load is P by 2. And this distance is how much? That is L by 4. Guys, this is L by 4. So this also will be L by 4. Because L by 4 plus L by 4 will be equal to L by 2. Anyway, so the bending moment is quite simple. It will bend the beam in this fashion. Clearly, hasta hua chara. It's a clear-cut case of sagging. Positive bending moment, load is P by 2 multiplied by L by 4. So PL upon 8. Just divide that bending moment by EI. Okay. So this is going to be PL over 8 EI. That is the bending moment for you. Right? I hope you are getting the idea. This is the first video of MAA moment area method. That is why I'm devoting time. Don't worry. As we go along, we'll be solving the problems very, very quickly. Okay? Fine. You'll get familiar with this technique. Right, so sum of parallel side, half of sum of parallel side. This side, height is how much? PL upon 4EI. This height of this side, well, that is PL upon 8EI. PL over 8EI. Multiplied by the distance between them. Okay, L. Parallel sides ki beech ki duri. Distance between the parallel side. This is how much? This is L by 4. So that essentially has to be multiplied with L by 4. Just try to solve this. Correct. What can be taken as common? So PL upon EI can be taken as common. So and 4 and 2 will become 8. Just watch this. 1 by 2 multiplied by this L by 4 multiplied by this PL upon EI, and inside the bracket what we have is 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8. And here this is slope at C. Not to worry, सब कुछ हो जाएगा. 1 बटा 4 और 1 बटा 8 भाई यहीं पे करते हैं ना. 1 बटा 4 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8. The LCM is going to be 8. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 2 plus 8 1s are 8, 1 into 1 is 1. This is 3 by 8. ठीक है, this result is 3 by 8. In the denominator we have 8. 8 multiplied by 4 is 32. 32 multiplied by 2 is 64. In the numerator we have 3. So this is going to be 3 by 64 PL upon EI. Once again, this works out as 3 by 8. So in the numerator, there is nothing but this 3, right? 3 into PL. So theta C, guys, is going to be equal to 3 times of PL over, in the denominator, what we have is this 8 multiplied. This result is 8 multiplied by 4. 4 is 32. 32 times is 64. This is going to be 64 times of EI. That's the result. Okay. What a samman dede. That is the result. Now let me be very honest with you. With practice, you can really work out or solve any slope problem within seconds, 15 to 20 seconds max. With practice, you can do that, right? You should be good at making the bending moment diagrams. And if you are, and if you know how to implement the technique, then things are going to get very easy for you. Aur kya nikalna hai? 1 minute, 1 second. Okay. Just look, that's it. Now we need to work out the value of slope at point A. Can be done. Again, just like B minus A, just try to do this. D minus A, theta D minus theta D, just try to apply, right? Let me just write this. Slope at A. Just try to apply theorem 1. What does theorem 1 say? Slope between, different difference of slope between two points, D and A, let's say theta D minus theta A is equal to area between these two points. That is the area that we are interested in. Ye purple color laga rahe hain bhaiya, dekhiye aap, ye purple color. Once again, theta D minus theta A, we already know what theta D is. It is equal to 0. We don't know theta A. What we'll try to do is area under M over EI diagram between points A and D, and that is the area that you need to work with. Beautiful. That is the area.
Purple color. पता नहीं कैमरा में दिखता भी है कि नहीं, कलर सस्ता कैमरा है ना, Redmi Note 5 Pro है, ठीक है. एरिया,
व्हाट इज दिस एरिया? ए डी ए डी डी डैश. दिस इज क्वाइट सिंपल गाइस. दिस इज ऑब्वियसली जीरो माइनस थीटा ए. एरिया इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ बेस. हाउ मच इज द बेस? दिस इज एल बाई टू. एंड व्हाट इज द हाइट? दिस हाइट इज नथिंग बट पी एल अपॉन फोर ई आई. पी L upon 4EI.
Okay. And obviously the answer is going to be 4 duni 8. 8 duni 16. Let me just make a quick check. Theta A is working out as,
look, we have a negative sign over here. The answer is negative. What does the negative sign signify?
Decreasing slope.
Here we go. Theta A is equal to minus of PL square upon 16EI. Again, this again is a very important result. Right?
Yeah, pretty good. Similarly, you can apply the same technique. Kahan banaye par? Yahan pe banate hain.
Let's make it over here.
Let's apply the theorem again.
Okay, just like B minus A, let's apply it for B minus D.
Slope at point B.
What? Slope at B. बोले तो theta B.
कैसे निकलेगा theta B?
Can be done very easily. Theta B minus theta A. Again, area under the M upon E I diagram between B and A. B, B or A नहीं मेरे भैया, B and D. B and D. Area under the M over EI diagram between B and D. B, D dash, D. B, D dash, D. Now you shall realize.
Here the answer worked out in negative sign. That means it was a case of decreasing slope. This is decreasing slope. Now you'll see at point B you'll get a positive slope. You'll realize this. Just a sec.
Theta B, well, we need to work it out. Minus theta D, we already know it is horizontal. That's why zero. Is equal to area. Area kitna ho jayega? Half of base. Base is gonna be it's L by 2. Height is how much? Height of the triangle PL upon 4EI. PL upon 4EI. This is fairly simple. You have the same result.
The slope at A and B is same, but the magnitude is slope in terms of magnitude is same, but the sign is different because at A we have a decreasing slope and at B we have an increasing slope. You can say this.
So theta B finally will be equal to PL upon, not L, PL square upon 4 duni 8, 8 duni 16, 16EI. That's it.
Okay. Just write this down. Case of increasing slope. Here, write down. Negative sign indicates a case of decreasing slope. Right? So, these were all the problems that I thought about explaining you all, and that's all for today. So if you are this way through the video, needless to say this, but do leave a like, do leave a comment, and let me know how the session was. So guys, that was all for today. I'll see you again in the next video with theorem number 2, and that is based on the difference of batayenge. Not to worry. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, take care, have a nice day, keep learning, keep watching, and thank you.